Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're doing another makeup tutorial. I don't really know what to call this. Could call it festival makeup, but all the festivals are canceled for this year in the summer, so we're rescheduled. So let's get started with this. I am starting with my foundation already done. I use the L'Oreal Infallible foundation. This has been my go-to recently. It makes your skin look airbrushed and amazing. So then I started to go in with concealer. This is the Kylie concealer that I'm putting on right now. And then you'll see that I overlay the Milani concealer on top of it. I've been really liking those combo together. And yeah. Then I'm just taking a beauty blender and I'm blending that all into my skin, making sure to press into the skin and not swiping or rubbing, because that will disrupt the foundation underneath the concealer. I really like the shade of these two concealers together as well, because it gives me a really nice lifting effect without looking too fake, but it's just bright enough so then I look awake and like I got sleep when I really haven't. Now I'm taking my sponge again and I'm actually using a new product to me. This is the Milk Makeup Matte Bronzer. It's in a stick and I kind of just rub the stick onto the sponge and press it into my skin. That way I don't get any harsh lines of just drawing it on my face. And I just work slowly and build this up because it is a little bit on the warm side and I don't want to look muddy or orange. So I'm just using that to kind of give me some shape and definition in my face before. That way I look like I have dimension and I don't look like a ghost. To set under my eyes, I'm just using a little bit of the normal powder that I always use. This is the Maybelline Loose Setting Powder, and I'm just kind of pressing it into my under eye. I'm really not baking like I normally do. I'm not taking as much powder as I do on a daily basis. I'm kind of just pressing it into the under eye and all the other high points that I want to set for the time being, and then that way it just sinks into my skin, fades into all my pores, and I still look nice and airbrushed, but I don't look cakey or too powdery. For my eyeshadow primer, I'm using the P. Louise eyeshadow base. I really like this when I'm doing colorful looks because it makes the eyeshadow pay off even better than normal. So I'm just using a flat brush and swiping it on my eyelids and then using the butt end of my beauty blender and I'm just pouncing that in. Then I'm just taking that pressed powder from Maybelline and a setting brush from Real Techniques and I'm just powdering everything down a little bit so then that way I don't get any skips in the eyeshadow and everything blends seamlessly, but I still get the color payoff that I want. Using this NYX palette, I've had this for a really long time, and using that lavender shade, it kind of came out a little bit more on the pink side when I put it on my eyelid, but I don't really care. I like how this eyeshadow look came out anyway. So I'm taking that into my crease with a fluffy brush from Morphe, and I'm just going into my crease and slightly winging it out, as you can see here on the outer edge. That way it kind of gives a lifting effect as we go further with this eye look. I'm always flicking out on the ends, so then that way you kind of get it a little bit more like cat eye on the side. I took my time building up the pigment, especially on the outer corners, and still flicking it out, and then going in with a clean, fluffy brush and blending out the edges. That way everything is nice and blown out and you don't have any harsh lines. Now with the lighter purple, I'm taking a little bit more of a dense brush and really going on the outside of the eyeshadow and blending it up until my brow bone. That way, I've talked about this before in a previous video, once I do my eyebrows, it's gonna look like the eyeshadow disappears into the brows and it looks even more blended. Now I'm taking this Huda Beauty palette and taking that really pretty purple shade and I'm starting on my actual eyelid and then I'm gonna work on the outside and a little bit more in the crease just to create some depth. Thank you. and I'm still making sure to take the brush and extend the eyeshadow look past my eye. That way we're still getting the winged out effect. This is one of my favorite highlighter palettes to play around with. This is the Moonchild Glow Kit from Anastasia, and I'm just going into the purple horseshoe shade, and I'm putting this in my inner corners. I think this looked really pretty up against the eyeshadow colors we've already done, and I'm going to use this as my face highlight in a little bit, but for now I just put it on the inner corners, and I'm putting it also on my eyelid. That way it'll be really nice to be underneath the glitter we're going to use as well. Wanting to make the inner corner a little bit more intense, so I took a more packed brush and I made it damp with some setting spray and packed on more of the highlight. Back to using this purple shade from the Huda Beauty palette, and now I'm taking a more flat brush and we're gonna do a shadow wing. I've done this before on my channel. Just extend your bottom lash line up, and then your wing will probably be really easy to do because you're just following that lower lash line. That way it doesn't look weird, or if you have a hooded eye like I do, it won't disappear. So that's what that looks like. I really like doing a shadow wing. It's so much easier to do than normal liner. It's less intimidating. And then I'm just running that on my lower lash line as well. For glitter, I'm using this pressed glitter from ColourPop. It's called Get Lost. I really, really love their pressed glitters. Just make sure that you press onto your eyelid when using these and use your finger because it adheres more. I feel like if you try and rub these on your eyelid, it just goes everywhere and they're not really intended for the immediate eye area. That's what it says, but I don't really wear these kind of looks for too long, so I don't have to worry about it. But when you are putting them on the eyelid, just make sure to pat and don't rub them because the glitter will get everywhere and in your lashes. Now I'm just wiping off any excess powder if there is any. And since there was a little bit of powder there, it caught some of the glitter particles that may have fallen down. So I was just using that to brush them off as well. And then I'm just powdering the rest of my face with the same powder I always do, Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder in Fair Light. It's really great to make your pores disappear and set your face for the whole day. I'm setting the cream bronzer from Milk Makeup with the butter bronzer. It's a powder formula. I personally cannot leave creams on their own. My face will literally break them down and it'll look crazy. So I have to set that cream contour slash bronzer with a powder one. So I'm just doing all the normal points that I would normally bronze and contour. And I love this bronzer. It's amazing. It smells really good and it doesn't look too crazy. I know the coloring of this video makes it look like my face is orange, but I promise in real life it wasn't. And here I am using the Milani Rose D'Oro blush with a big powder brush, and I'm putting this everywhere because I love blush so much. So if you ever feel like your face is starting to look a little cakey or it's building up anywhere, take the clean side of your beauty blender and spray it with any kind of face mist and then pounce it all over your face. The damp sponge will just make sure to melt any of the excess powders away, and then that way it'll soak up any of the cakiness. For highlight, I'm starting with the Fenty Beauty Sandcastle Highlighter, and I love this highlighter. Used it before. It's such a good formula. It melts right into the skin. It doesn't look crazy. I needed a base before I used the purple highlight just so it didn't look too intense. So I'm using this first and putting it all over my face like I normally do highlight because I love highlighter. Now I'm using the Fun Purple Horseshoe shade from the Moonchild Glow Kit, and I'm going to do the same thing but just overlaying it on top of the Fenty Beauty highlighter. That way when I turn, my cheek doesn't have like a horrible purple cast. It kind of just has like a hint of it, and I'm just putting that all over the place again like I did the previous highlight. toward the lower lash line, I kept it pretty simple. I just went back into that NYX palette and ran some of the purple shadow underneath my eye. That way it's not too heavy, it keeps that part nice and bright and open. For my brows, I did them off camera. I did them in the previous video, so I felt like it was unnecessary. And I did my mascara as well, using the same Maybelline mascara that I always do. But if you forgot, I'll leave it in the description below. I wanted to do two different lip combos. This is gonna be the first one. It's a little bit more out there, and I'm gonna do a more natural one as the second look. But this is the Kylie Cosmetics Velvet Lipstick in the shade Grape Soda. And I started with patting it in the center, and I'm gonna work my way out towards my actual lip line. And as you can see, I'm just blending that. And I'm going to take a Maybelline Super Stay ink crayon right here. I'm kind of out of frame, I'm sorry. And I'm just kind of using this as a lip liner and blending it into the purple liquid lipstick. That way it has some kind of depth to it and it's not just straight purple. And then for this lip option, I topped it with a Fenty Beauty gloss. I believe this was a limited item for last summer's line, but it has a really cool purple shift to it. So I wanted to top it with this more fun out there look. This isn't everybody's cup of tea, but in the next clip, I will show you a more muted version of a lip option. If you're not as crazy as me to do this. I really liked the combo of this purple lip with like the purpley pink eye. So I'm wiping off the crazy purple lip if you're not into that. And honestly, you can use whatever nude lipstick you want if that's what you want to go for. I just chose to use a Kylie Jenner lipstick. They're really similar to the ColourPop ones because they're probably the same formula, but they're just upped in price, but we won't talk about that. This is the shade, I believe, Dolce de Leche. I really like this because it has a hint of pinky in it, but it's still like a little bit more of a neutral, not so mauve color, and I like that. So I just applied that really simply, nothing too crazy about it, left the lips for this option pretty plain. That's it for this makeup tutorial, and let's go on to the outro. I'm out of breath. I just ran outside and took pictures in like direct sunlight so it could really capture the glitter. But I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm sorry for all of the voiceover videos that have been uploaded and will be uploaded until I'm out of quarantine. It's just easier for me to do voiceovers, that way I'm not talking and looking like a crazy person in front of my family. I hope everyone is doing well out there and staying healthy and doing your part to social distance and stay inside as much as possible, because that's really important right now if we want to go back to real life. So again, thank you for watching this video. If you have any comments, concerns, questions you would like to ask me, talk to me below in the comments. I'm very bored these days. I hope you enjoyed this makeup look. I enjoyed making it as always, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye.